Thursday night was an emotional milestone for Greg and Kara Olsen. Their twins, TJ and Talbot, celebrated their second birthday on an occasion some worried TJ might never see. He was born with one side of his heart severely underdeveloped, a defect called hypoplastic left heart syndrome. TJ has grown up in the hospital and already survived 3 open heart surgeries. Now with the hardest yards hopefully behind them, the Olsens are paying it forward. Jen Hale has more.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
So May of 2012, my wife and I just went for a routine 18-week sonogram. We were hoping to find out the sex of the babies. That's when it all changed. The sonographer picked up a little discrepancy on the ultrasound.
I think of that moment, I just wanted to crawl into a cave and never come out, because you never want anything wrong with your child, especially something as severe as what TJ was diagnosed with.
It was a very, very difficult time in our house. There was a lot of uncertainty and a lot of sleepless nights.
People ask me why I think so hard.
I can put myself right back in that car driving home, crying, you know, trying to figure out where to go from here.
It's a long way back home.
We try to give parents and families as much information as we can. We try to paint a realistic picture.
Some parents have a choice to make. There's a compassionate care choice,
right?
That it sounds like you guys had decided to fight from the very beginning.
Yeah, I think it was about what they say, 60% of people decide to terminate these babies, and then there's another percent that decide to just let them live for however, I think they can live up to a week.
You know, families may not want to put their child through those operations for, you know, whatever the reasons.
Statistically, 97% of our patients do great, 3% don't. It's the 3% that make you wonder how long you can keep doing this, to be quite honest. There is a lot of sacrifice involved, but again, it's exceptionally worth it.
You know, we had to give him a shot, you know. It would have been unfair, you know.
It would have been selfish on our part, yeah, not to give him that opportunity. That would have been looking more for our sake than his.
Yeah.
And we weren't willing to let that be the reason that our son didn't have a chance.
I got my football. I got my eyes opening, my mouth moving. Say night night, mommy. I see you tomorrow.
Instantly, when you have your child, you love them. You know, you can't even put into words how much you love your child. And there was so much fear for him. And then, like with this last surgery, you know, having to see him go through pain and him look at me and say, "Why is this happening to me, mom?" And looking at Craig, and
that was
really difficult, this last surgery. But he's so tough.
This most recent surgery, you know, being there for 4 weeks, him being almost 2 years old, he was very aware of what was happening. He was very, you know, uncomfortable, couldn't understand what was going on.
How did you find the strength to get through that?
I got my strength from you.
Thank you.
I mean, honestly, it was not a day that Greg didn't look at the positive in every situation we've been dealt the past 2 years. Well, 2.5 years. And it gave me such strength, you know. I would say I had multiple moments of, you know, weak moments, and he would just always look at the positive side.
We've all had our moments over the last couple years where, you know, the other person then had to jump in and kind of spark some life back in and spark some positivity and optimism. So it's been a group collective effort.
And what does TJ's future look like?
You know, we know down the road we're going to have to deal with something. You know, a lot of these people do need heart transplants down the road, but
today, right now, he's as happy, as healthy, and as normal as his sister and his brother. And we're not going to live today worrying about tomorrow, because then we'll never, ever be able to move forward.
At quarterback, from the University of Miami, number 88, TJ Olsen.
What was it like when you got to bring him home from the hospital this last time?
I think I was just like, hallelujah, you know, 4 weeks in the hospital.
There's no daddy.
It was a long road to see him on that sideline. It all kind of came to a head that day.
The best thing about it is my little guy got to be here and see me play for the first time, and You know, that just got the day started off right, being able to give him a hug on the field.
I think it's put everything into perspective.
That sense of normalcy was taken away from us for a little while, and when it's taken away, you realize how much you just want it back. You know, you don't wish for any of the extras anymore. We're gonna enjoy every day we have with him, because we don't know what tomorrow's gonna bring.
Oh.
There's a 25% chance TJ will still need a heart transplant, but the Olsens are focused on providing a normal childhood for him and others fighting similar battles. They've started the Hardest Yard Foundation, which provides families with expensive but potentially life-saving home care when these young patients get to go home in between surgeries.